Then I got the strike. Thank you, Tyler. All right, let's play ball.
I just had a couple questions. You know, is it a GoPro?
Yeah, it's a GoPro. You can sync it with a phone. You can stream.
I just bought.
Pitching for Napa, number 11, Braden Butler. Catching for Napa, number 17, Diego Hernandez.
And I want to
say, that's good.
Yeah.
So I'm curious what it looked like. And I didn't know that. But
you can get this little mount. You can get it online. It'll mount the chain link. It'll mount wherever. Put a big SD card in it. Portable battery pack, and we can stream, or we can it'll record to the SD card at the same time.
So. Oh, okay, stream and record.
Yeah.
Where does it stream to?
Facebook.
No way.
Yeah.
How about the one where you clip it to the fence? That looks a little nice.
Oh, it's way secure. You can adjust it to get it right in the in the opening of that one of the pieces of link and.
I just bought it yesterday, so it's coming in. But I bought an SD card for it. Remote control too, right?
With the app. This is in the app right now because it's streaming right now.
Facebook app?
No, it's a GoPro app. GoPro Quick app. You can download that to your phone.
And you control from there? All you could do with that is edit.
That to your phone, right. And then use your phone. Okay.
The Bluetooth.
It uses Wi-Fi.
Does it?
Yeah. And a combination of Bluetooth sometimes, depending on what you're trying to do, but it syncs with Wi-Fi.
Huh. Okay. I bought the remote, good for myself the remote.
Mm-hmm.
So I bought the remote thinking that's going to be possible. But you said just
the phone. The phone.
It makes sense with it.
And you don't see it in this screen, but you can actually get a preview of what the camera's seeing. So you can change all the settings from
4K.
The phone without having to go back to the camera.
Oh, that's awesome. What do you guys record on?
It's 720. Or we're streaming at 720. We'll record at
1080p or
something like that.
Not 4K.
No, there's really no reason. The picture is pretty good. Now, the only drawback is you get a great field of view, but you can kind of see what's going on in the infield and in the outfield. If you don't know who's out there, you can't
tell who they're out there. I'm thinking of pictures of the spider thing. It's like a grab one of those. And then obviously it's a carrying case. It's interesting. I don't think it will get, but not enough light when you lower it. Okay. To mix that.
An indoor, outdoor. Sucks up here because the cell service isn't that great, so the screen might may drop.
Because
it's down.
I wanted to just have memories. So.
Oh, yeah.
And then you stream to Facebook.
You can stream to Facebook, you can stream. It gives you a whole list. You can stream directly to the website. If you have a website, you want to stream it. Or you can just save it. Typically not. Pretty much just stream to Facebook.
Right.
Because the way GoPros work is if you have a 2-hour video, it segments it on an SD card into, I want to say, 15-minute blocks. So in order to post it on YouTube, you have to merge those. You merge it and then you can get a full length video. A lot of the stuff we're seeing is close to
Say, like, if you're recording a game, it's going to catch you is Jason Knapp, and the picture is, and then it just follows him around the screen until he needs the screen for whatever he needs to work.
I don't know if there's AI that will work to be able to identify that particular player and say, okay, here's this little guy.
Sure. Because then it would be a concept of view. It goes up to the touches here and it just kind of floats by. And then when the sun is back to the
when we have better Wi-Fi, we also have an iPad. Yeah, game changer. Embed video into that scoring program now. Or last year it was team manager, now it's new game changer, is what they call it. It'll embed video into the scoring program, so it'll have the video and then the score.
Right.
And then you can see who's where when you're looking at game changer and you're doing that. So,
you got the game changer too?
So. Yeah. But like I said, most of the time we have iPads on next to that. The signal's so weak here, I can't see both of them off my phone.
Yeah. I looked up Game Changer at this time. I'm just managing my iPad. I was like, I don't want to use Game Changer. I just did Team Snap only for notifications. That's it.
Yeah.
That's all I'm using Team Snap for is, hey, I want to get a game today or whatever it's going to do. But I don't track or sell or I'm sure you've experienced Team Snap too.
Yeah, yeah. We've, as a team, we've never scored through Team Snap at all. And you can set it up so that anytime the travel changes, it'll notify
it, right?
Or it'll sync with the calendar. So it's a pretty good program.
Maybe next time.
And I don't know.
Keep track of the stats team, right?
Oh, yeah.
If you want to do
it. Oh, yeah. Automatically. Yeah. Your book's all that stuff. And then it has a live view, so you can actually watch the
Facebook live view.
But then it also just in that the balls and strikes and everything like that.
She needs someone to throw something up to the spot, right?
Well, that's what we use the score.
Oh, you do?
Don't keep the Facebook. That's how it is.
Yeah, that's good.
The only thing I don't like about that personally is I haven't scored enough games to really confident in it because when I get behind a table, I can move
the guys
and go better and then fix my messed up.
What's your name?
We can take now, right?
First up, for fastball, strike one, Brady Allen, shortstop, number 27. Number two, Spencer Mathis. He's your catch.
Go! just roll it up.
Next to bat, number 9, Gage Scarrett. Use your pigeon.
Yeah.
Hey, let's go play catch, gang.
Maybe sit at the camera there. That's to make sure it's still streaming. I'm owning Kitty.
One did go to the backstop, so it's all good.
Is that two games?
Yeah.
Just an announcement to let you know that you can pre-order your lunch now, and it'll be ready for you at noon or around 12:30. We have hamburgers and hot dogs, so you might want to pre-order those, and they'll be ready for you. First attack, number 9, Blake Porter. Next up, number 11, Brayden Butler. Sawyer Carmichael.
What happened to the lawn?
He died a little bit. I got you.
Yeah.
please welcome to the plate number four, Tanner Boyce. He plays third base. Now coming back, first baseman, Charlie Kramer, number 20.
Four. All right. Ready? Get on time. Get on time. trying to get it done.
That one. A little sooner.
Now coming to bat, number 10, Kenny Weeks. He plays right field. Next up for Napa, number 12, Travis Larson.
Back.
Now for Napa number 17, Diego Hernandez. Next at bat, number 4, Charlie Yim.
$5 worth and $5 worth.
Back for FBK1 is number 3, Cam Perkins plays left field. Next up is number 79, Jaden Evanstar.
Warming up, 2-9.
Back to the top of the order, number 27, Grady Allen.
Come on.
Next to bat for Napa, number 11, Braden Butler. Next to bat, number 7, Sawyer Carmichael. Next up for Napa, number 12, Travis Larson.
Coming out here. down too. Knock him down.
Next up for Napa, number 17, Diego Hernandez. Next up for Napa.
my money at
the field.
Get after Napa number four.
Mine's off an hour.
It's supposed to be at 10 in the morning.
Make it work.
Next up, number 12, Travis Arsene. Next up for Napa, number 25, Sam Motka.
go low. You got to do
it. Double cheeseburger.
I gotta break off the season and get started. I'm not ready for the last one. That's what I thought too. But they showed up.
Next up for Napa, number 17, Diego Hernandez. Next up, number 22, Andrew Douglas. Up next for Napa, number 15, Peter Trovich.
All right.
12-1 lead after 4 innings. They have a 12-1 lead after 4 innings.